Welcome back to the channel. We're in today for a full day, a day in the life, basically. So today is a busy enough day. So I actually have a client over from Ireland. So we're going to go down to Ultraflex and he is doing a photo shoot. So an 18-week prep leads to today and he came over here for it, which I'm really excited for. And I have two clients back in Ireland doing shoots today as well. So you'll kind of see me with Niall today in Ultraflex, kind of running through his shoot day and kind of what that entails. And then obviously we're going back and forth with clients as well to make sure later on in the day they're bang on for their shoots too. So yeah, pretty busy morning. But I'm going to get cracking on my first meal here and then we're going to head down to Ultraflex. So this is actually what I do with salt. So I have 12 grams of salt per day. So I actually pour it into this at the start of the day. And then I know that's 12 grams. And then as the meals come, I'll just divide it out equally across the six meals. Just so I know exactly how much salt I'm getting in and not just kind of winging it. But the first meal, we have 100 grams of rice. We have 200 grams of mince. And then 30 grams of peppers with mustard, 2 grams of salt, and then this is the season I use as well. So I use that on all meals. I use mustard on all meals as well. So that's the first meal with 100 grams of berries, which I'll get ready now. And then the second meal is going to be the same with the rice, the mince, the peppers, but I'm going to have 100 grams of pineapple with this, which I'll show you when I'm having it. But I'm bringing this with me because I probably have to have this at the shoe. So prepared. Grams of berries. I always go with frozen berries. I prefer frozen than fresh. Fresh blueberries are okay, but especially strawberries. Fresh strawberries are way nicer than frozen, but I think frozen blueberries are better than fresh blueberries. So just my thoughts. Someone probably disagree with that. And actually, I've got my pineapple ready, which I've changed to frozen pineapple. I was using the tinned pineapple before, but the tinned tasted too good. So I got to a stage of prep where I was like, this is too good. I feel like I'm cheating here. So I switched over to frozen. It's not as nice, but. Yeah, take them and a bit of jam now. Just bring them in there with you. Do you have your salt as well? Please, a bit of salt, yeah. 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 Okay. Just collected P-Vite. So, it's 7:45, so we're gonna head to the shop. We have to get a couple of bits, head down to the gym, get him pumped up, get him oiled up, and then we are good to go. So, yeah, I think this will be interesting. It looks really, really good as well. Really good. Obviously, we started like 2 years ago as well. So I'll show you kind of the changes that we've made as well so far, but yeah, I'll tell you that later on. You'll see as we go. With P-Vite here, basically before the shoot, you want to get some sort of pump up. So the goal here is just to get some blood into the muscle. So, you know, we're looking at his chest, his shoulders, his arms, his back, and just doing like, you know, whatever he needs to do just to get blood into that muscle and feel things kind of popping and firing up a bit more, because the shoot is going to be hard. We're going to, you know, when you're posing, when you're tensing, it's going to be difficult. So you are going to be pumped from that alone. We're just getting some blood in there, first of all, just so, you know, everyone looks better with a pump. So getting pumped up before, just so when you go in, you know, you're going to look full. You're going to look like, you know, more vascular, etc. So, yeah, nothing crazy. Not trying to hit PBs or break down any tissue. Just literally get some blood in here. What are we going to use this for? I've been really trying, baby. Trying to hold back this feeling for so long. And if you... Right, so as you can see, I'm very, very happy with how he looks. He's very happy as well. You know, he's tight, he's sharp. I think these pictures are gonna be crazy. Right, so with Niall's prep, I think it's been 18 weeks we prepped for. So we've actually been working together for the last 2 years. And when he came to me, he didn't have any muscle really whatsoever. He was pretty skinny. He'll tell you this himself. I'll put pictures up too. But initially the goal was, look, we want to gain muscle, we want to gain size, we want to get heavier. So that's what we done. We went into a big off season and we done a dieting phase once we had that first push-up phase. And then once we had that dieting phase, then we pushed up again. So two push-ups, one mini cut, and then into this prep here. And the amount of muscle added in that time frame has been substantial, just from kind of people learning how to train properly, how to obviously fuel his body, how to train from an execution standpoint, but also from a training intensity standpoint, which a lot of people lack. So now the fact that he can train to failure, you know, he can really train extremely well in terms of execution as well. You know, this is why he's grown the way he has, obviously in terms of nutrition stuff as well. That's super important, but his nutrition can be bang on, but if his training isn't where it needs to be either, he's not gonna get the results like he has. So this one just started the journey, as he will tell you as well. You know, we have big plans of kind of what's to come too, so I'm super excited. You know, when it comes to a photo shoot prep, I find it's a fantastic opportunity for someone, not just the physical aspects, from a mental aspect as well. What you learn through a photo shoot prep or contest prep in terms of like discipline, you know, structure, routine, and just realizing maybe what you're capable of that you probably didn't realize before. I think it's, you know, it's invaluable, you know, it's priceless. And that then can be taken into other aspects such as business, relationships, other areas in life, whatever it may be, you know, from what this has taught you. So physical progress is great, but it's the mental and what it teaches you, which, you know, I would highly recommend it to absolutely anybody. You don't have to be, you know, at a certain standard or anything. You have to be at your own standards, you know, not comparing yourself to anyone else and just being the best version of you. If you compare yourself to anyone else that's doing shoots, etc., you'll just never do it because you'll always want to be better. Peavy, we started working together in 2021, so 2 years ago. We actually went to school together, so this comes back around full circle. But obviously after school, like obviously everyone goes separate ways, you know. We didn't really chat or anything, and then we're still following each other, and then obviously he reached out for coaching. Why did you reach out for coaching in the first place? You're a lot different to now.
Yeah, basically I was training and I was getting nowhere, so I said he was the one guy that I could reach out. Obviously I followed Mark on Instagram and I was like, right, I'm comfortable with Mark, as Mark was saying, we were good mates in school, so I dropped him a text and the rest is history. Here we are today, 2 years on. Yeah, it's a proud moment, like, you know. Yeah. Really is. It's brilliant. Like, I'm really grateful for you. Like, you know, really am.
We had this discussion yesterday as well.
Yeah.
Kind of like, if it's like, if you're new in the gym or anything, like, what you say is like, it's silly if you don't have a coach.
Yeah. It's like, because I was training. Like, I did a trial electrician, so I was training, but I was living away from home for 6 months in college, and I was training. I was getting nowhere, not eating the right stuff. And as soon as I changed and got in contact with you, the meal plans, just the routine really fucking helped me train and just showing up, like, you know, it's brilliant, like, really is brilliant.
The first check-in to now, like, not just physically, but in terms of, like,
mentally
confidence-wise, like, different person.
Totally changed, came out of my shell, it's just, I don't even know how to describe it, it's just madness, like, you've changed, like, and I know you're only coaching me in the gym, but, like, the impact you've had on me, man, outside the gym, like, pushing me forward is just amazing. Like, and it honestly is, like, can't be so much more grateful for you. Like, you know, it honestly is, like,
appreciate
it's that. Mad. Like, that's what I'm saying. And I wish everyone could feel, as we were saying yesterday, that feeling of going to the gym and feeling that. And then, obviously, you know you're getting somewhere because you have the coach in you. And then you just show up and do it. Cook your meals, show up, and then results come. And your whole bleeding mindset changes totally, like, you know, it's brilliant. It really is fucking brilliant, like, you know, it's brilliant.
You fell in love with the process.
Oh, I fell in love with the process,
When you fall in love with the process, man, like, that's why you said, like, if we want people to feel that, man. Because, like,
100%. That's when people ask me out and, like, why do you go to the gym? And I say, just try it for a while and feel what, I'd be like, it's madness. Like, some days you don't even want to train. Then you go into training, you're like, holy God, put you straight into a good mood, straight away.
Something I actually discussed with Aaron earlier as well is that we live in a society now that nobody wants to do anything difficult. Nobody wants to like get outside their comfort zone or work for anything. Listen, you know, because they don't have to.
Like that's, prep has opened my whole world of like trying to change, as we discussed yesterday in the car, what I'm trying to change and stuff. It's just madness. I never thought like I'd be here doing all that stuff, you know. I always doubted myself, and that's what I'm saying, the impact outside the gym, not even in the gym that you had with me, is just madness, like, you know. It really is madness.
I think what a lot of people fail to realize is that if you are someone who's like, you know, like lifestyle based too, you started off as like a lifestyle client, basically, you know, not wanting to do a shoot, not wanting to compete.
Yeah, just remember, I remember where I was and everything. I was in the shop and I said, ah, oh, you were like, you want to do a shoot at the end? It's just like, ah, oh, it's not for me. I don't feel comfortable. And you were like, look, let's just build into and see where it goes. And here we are today. Like,
you're bitten,
you know,
by the bug. Usually after a shoot, you just want to shower. You had to shower because...
I had to shower. That's why everybody big fucking wet head in me here.
The first thing you want to do is just shower, get that time off.
It's all good, yeah.
We drive back to ours. You get some food, get a flight home.
Fly home, yeah. And that's a wrap. That's it.
Yeah, perfect. 18 weeks over like that.
It's emotional, man. It's emotional.
P-Boy's shoot is over. There he is. He's happy with his rice cakes and jam. Jam's actually going to make him oats when we go back as well. But this is my meal on the go. The meal from this morning. So 100 grams of rice, 200 mince, 30 peppers again. And then we have 100 pineapple. So this is meal two. It's 10 past 10, so this will be in the next 10 minutes. This is the meal before pre-workout. So pre-workout will go in about 12, because today is a training day. So we actually have push today. So meal two, we'll go back, sort ourselves, meal three, and then trains. I actually had a new low today. So 122.6. And usually after a rest day, I come back up. But after leg day, I come down. So I came down to 122.8. And then usually the day after that, I come back up a little bit. But yesterday I actually came down again. So things are moving nicely at the moment. Tomorrow I'll definitely drop again, just from actually socializing and sitting, like talking to people and being here today. That is completely different to what I do on a day-to-day basis. So even socializing, we'll see a drop coming. It's absolutely crazy. So yeah, I already feel like I've dropped today already. So I reckon tomorrow morning will be a good chunk tighter. I'm actually going to get cracking on P-Boy's reverse here, and kind of his plan of action for moving forward, because like he said, there's no messing about with him. He wants to really get into reverse straight away and not mess about. And I think that's extremely important. When coming out the back of a dieting phase, like I said before, your dieting phase doesn't end when a diet's over. You know, it finishes when you reverse out of the diet, because that's the most difficult part. So I think it's super, super important to, you know, have a plan in place coming out of the back of that, in terms of like having structure with your foods, bringing the food up to where it needs to be, maybe incorporating a couple of things that you've been craving, etc., into the plan as well. So you can have that better balance and you can enjoy things that you haven't been able to have while still keeping a hold on things. So I think the most important thing is not coming out of the back of a dieting phase and being like, grand, I'm finished the diet, game on, I can just eat whatever I want and, you know, grow, because you're gonna gain body fat very, very fast. So actually having structure in place, because if you have structure in place and you have a goal for going forward straight away, it's going to be easier for you to kind of stay focused, because you have a plan, you know, you have the reverse set in stone, and you have a goal that you have to actually work towards as well. So I think that's important, having that mapped out, having that prepared, organized, so then, you know, a couple of days after shoot, you're back on, you have everything laid out and it's ready to go. And super, super important. So we just went through a few bits there in terms of, like, you know, what he's thinking in terms of food, etc. too. So I'm gonna make a few adjustments to his food. I'm gonna kind of map out the timeline for him as well. So you would actually see here in the timeline, I'm kind of gonna map out the next few months. I'm gonna reverse engineer, because, you know, he does eventually want to step on stage. But I'm gonna kind of look a few years down the line and be like, right, what way are we gonna work this? You know, pick a time frame of when I think potentially, you know, he's going to be ready to step on stage, and then work back from this and break it down into gaining phases and dieting phases and mini cuts, etc., when I feel it's necessary. You know, I know P-Boy's body after 2 years of working with him, so I know how long we can push up for, how long we need to pull back, etc. as well. So I'm going to kind of map this out now, so that when he looks at this when he gets home, he's going to have literally the next like 18 months to 24 months mapped out in terms of, right, I know what phase I'm going to be in, and straight away there's a goal set, and he's not just in no man's land and finding it difficult to have any sort of structure and focus after shoots. So yeah, I'm going to map out timeline for him, and I'm going to adjust his food slightly as well, so that when he gets home, you know, he'll have purpose and focus and doesn't feel like he's in that stage of post-shoot blues, which is a thing. I never actually have to iron my clothes because they never crease, but this one is pretty bad. I'm domestic goddess in this house. Jen does not know how to iron. Literally does not know how to iron. Never learns. That's what happens when you're posh and rich. But yeah, push day. We have pre-workout meal going in now. I've actually ate a banana already. Okay, so I'll just show you what banana is there. That's a banana, right? That's what a banana is, yeah. We've had 150 banana, 60 whey. So I actually make that into paste. Okay, so like it is there. If you drink your whey, you're doing something wrong. I have 125 grams of rice, which I will have in a second. But I'll iron this, eat the rest of that, and then get my shit sorted. I'm gonna get intra sorted, post-workout sorted. Pre-workout today. I never have pre-workout in off-season. In prep, especially now, I think a pump product, when you're feeling that bit flatter. So I have Vascomax here, and I have a black coffee as well. So anything too steamy, like, you know, something very high in caffeine, etc., I can't. I get a bad calm down off it. It doesn't agree with me. So black coffee and this would be perfect. I'm not sponsored by Strom, even though it would be fucking great, but I love this. That is pre. I'll have that in the coffee on the way. I have my intra here. So we have 60 grams of the Conte Carb Drive. We have 20 grams of EAS, 5 grams creatine, 5 grams glutamine in this. And I have post-workout here, which I will show you after the session. But I'm just finishing my 125 grams of rice for pre-workout, and then we will hit the road in a few minutes. That's it. I haven't missed anything. Sure, I haven't.
I have my coffee in a protein shaker because...
Tell them how many coffees is in that.
It's only... I will say it's 3 shots, and everyone else will say 3 shots is nothing.
I only have 1 shot and my head has been blown off.
No, to be fair, when you go to Starbucks, it's free espressos for like...
It's immediately like regular, yeah. It is.
Wake up. Blow sick, man, I've been high. I saw a guy who the dopest, hopeless. What I used to be, now I'm moving packs of that potent pressure. If love is a drug, I need extra. I don't look to people, look to the one who poured and don't even measure. Killing beasts, give me pleasure. Please got a man.
Post workout meal. I have everything here. I'm someone who puts them in different compartments, and this meal does not go together. Someone's gonna look at this and be like, what are these doing together? But I have 200 grams of blueberries. I have 60 grams of whey, which I will make into paste in a second. And then I have 125 grams of rice. So, random meal, random food choices, but as I always say, for me, there's not many things that I digest well with me. So this is perfect. It goes down well, and that is all I care about. Okay, so post-workout meal, I'll have this. It's about like 25 minutes after I finished the session now. I went up, posed, came back down, kind of decompressed. I'll eat this now. Get home, and then we go from there. You make the sludge. You add some water in. You stir it. And if it's still not enough water, you'll add some more in, but don't forget, if you add too much in, you can't go back. But if you don't add enough in, you can put more in. So just don't put too much in. And just make, I think I might need some. Maybe a bit more. Okay. So for anyone who hasn't seen it before, what I do, I don't meal prep and make all my meals at once. I literally just make a big batch of rice, make a batch of chicken, make a batch of mince. That is my meals prep for a few days. So then when I go to have a meal, all I do is take the rice out or chicken out, and just pop it into the box because it's already ready. Takes like 40 seconds to divide it into a lunchbox and a meal is ready. That way, there's not too much space in the fridge and other meals are already made, so it's handy. Man, the rice is bad. But I'm just gonna close my eyes and pretend it's pizza.
Is that what you do for all your meals? It's the only way to get through it.
I think I'm a pretty good cook, to be fair. Mark's gonna be a bit out for tonight. Ah, got it. So we're back from training. I'm gonna have my next meal in about 10 minutes, which will be about 6:30, which will be this meal. So we have 200 grams of chicken, 100 grams of rice, 30 peppers as well, mustard, the seasoning, and the salt, and 100 grams of apple. I'll have that one in 10 minutes. And then Aaron's gonna shoot off. I'm not gonna hold him around until the last meal. So my final meal is going to be 75 rice, 200 mince. It's going to be the 30 peppers as well. I just haven't put it in yet because I'm going to put this in the microwave. And then 100 grams of pineapple with that meal as well. So that is the game plan for the next two meals. It's been a long couple of days, hasn't it, Jem?
It's been a long, long couple of days.
So we are just going to, like, I'm going to just have that meal and just try and chill out, put my feet up and relax. I don't have any more work to go through this evening. It's a Saturday evening, so a couple of messages, you know, just before that meal, the next 10 minutes, and then that's me wrapped up. So Fubar, that's what we're watching, actually, Fubar. So we'll watch that, and then we'll get an early night, have a good night's sleep, and then, yeah, fresh start tomorrow. Pull day for me tomorrow. Food I'm eating now, in comparison to, you know, what was that peak off season two. Obviously, there's a big difference, but as you will see, the exact same foods. All it is different amounts, you know. So, you know, when people go into a dieting phase, and they may think there's a special diet to lose body fat, etc. You know, it's just controlling the energy balance. And to do that, you know, I'm happy with the meals I'm eating. I enjoy them. So it's just manipulating the meals then to pull us down into a deficit from there. So that's why the meals are the exact same, just different amounts, less in a diet, more in off season. That's all it is. 11 weeks out, as I said, for the 24th time, I'm just enjoying it. And it's fun at the moment until we start hating each other in a few weeks. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I appreciate it. And like, share, subscribe. It would mean a lot. And I will catch you in the next one. This is hard, right? And I'm spending so long on it and nothing's even happened.
So I remember. You don't know how to iron either.
No, I do. I remember, right, one time when I was younger, I used to love ironing the clothes. And I used to beg my mum, can I iron the clothes, right? And one day, right, I was ironing.
This is how they bring them up in Ireland.
I was ironing, and my mum was upstairs. She called me. And she came back, I was like, yeah. She was like, come here, I was like, grand. And I went to walk upstairs and I put the iron on my fingers and like ripped all the skin off. It was disgusting. I remember it to this day.
Lovely.
It was disgusting. So then she wouldn't let me iron after that. And I was begging, I was like, please let me iron the clothes.
And now you're like, Jem, fuck's sake, why don't you know how to iron?
Why don't you know how to iron?
Why are my clothes even for me?